Thanks to you all for coming, actually, so showing up. Yeah, my name is Wahib. I'm an Android developer at KI Labs here in Munich. And how many developers are there in the audience? Or people who like to call themselves developers? Cool. Any mobile developer? Awesome. So yeah, most of my examples might be in context of Android. So yeah, anyways, this talk is about why is there's a need to for developers to show empathy towards the users, what stops them, and how what we can do about it. So yeah, I'm originally from Pakistan. This is a real picture of a wheelchair ramp in my city in Islamabad. And don't ask me why, but it makes you wonder what in the world, holy shit, this guy was thinking when he was building it, right? Like, this is a perfect example of why when we're building something just for the sake of it, just get done with our job, blindly following instructions without caring about our end users, without even caring how much painful and disastrous it could be for your end users. So this is like a perfect example I could use. Empathy is basically a genuine effort to understand the perspective of your users, to see their pain, and to actually, without being judgmental. And I think the bottom line of showing empathy is to build the right product for our users and which adds real value to in their lives. This is Fibario. It's one of the highest rating smart home apps on Google Play. And again, it makes you wonder what designer was thinking while designing this interface. But again, this is real stuff. Some real designer was behind that. But the point I want to make is that not the bad UX, but the for end user, it's very natural that when they see bad UI controls or bad visuals, they tend to blame the designer. But on the contrary, when they see a wrong error message or an app crash, we instantly try to blame developers and go on Google Play and give bad reviews minus like one or two. So this is like reflects our understanding of responsibilities and expectations. And I think this is something I wanted to talk about, that I believe that developers are equally responsible for bad user experience, and we need to talk about these fences we create around our job description. If you see this statement, look straightforward. Designers make designs, they approve designs. But how about if you flip the coin? And how come developers implement design which doesn't make sense? Why don't they think before implement? Why don't they share concerns before that? So this is like a very topic very close to my heart, and I really wanted to talk about it because this is a harsh reality. Developers need to always remember that whatever you do, how much cooler, hot shit developer you are, user experience will always trump technology. And yeah, let's talk about why does it happen. So ask versus them is a very common phenomena, generally used in human psychology, but it's, I want to refer it for between developers and designers. We all, developers work with designers, but we talk every day, but we tend to not understand their world and they don't to understand our world. There's always a gap between those two worlds of developers and designers. And I think this is extremely important to engage with your designers, to try to understand their challenges, help them understand your challenges, because this is the only way you can gel in together and work on single path to success for your users. And for me, it's an experience of working on closely with a designer to build a style guide for our previous product was extremely enlightening for me to understand their discipline and their craft. And it helped him to understand how we think, how developers think. Yeah, again, very huge misconception, especially among junior developers when they start their career, that, I was not hired for this shit. So this kind of attitude kind of stops us contributing to the real product. And with the passage of time, we all realize that actually we are hired for much more than that. Coding is just a little fraction of the reason why we were hired in the first place. But it comes with time, so it's important to keep in mind always, all the time. If a developer understands design, I think it adds delight to the work we already do. And if you try to involve yourself early in the design process, because it will help you understand ground realities, help you uncover design intent behind what designers have produced, and bring you closer to the users. But before that, before you can make any contribution to that, you need to understand the design principles. So pick a book on design principles, pick a book on usability, watch a podcast, but help you try to understand the language they speak. And most importantly, especially for mobile developers, it's extremely vital for us to understand the best practices and principles of our own design guidelines. For example, Android has material design guidelines. It's extremely important for us as developers to know which UI control to use when, and why does it even exist in the first place? And many times I have personally observed that designers depend on us, they see us as an expert on those domains to help them make the right choices for the design items. For example, which button to use, which scroll bar to use, and if we are not aware of it, how can we help our designer to build the right tool? Being proactive prevents problems. Being proactive means that we are really investing our time, resources, and energy towards our goal. The goal is to build the right product for our users. There's another misconception that only there's a guy hired project manager who is only responsible for building the right thing for our users. We'll just take a task from Jira and just gonna do it. But this is where things go wrong because you are equally responsible. And if the both of them take care of the users, only then you can build the right product. So don't hesitate asking the tough questions to your PM. Don't hesitate in sharing concerns early as possible. Something which worked for me really well was that I worked very closely with the project owner. And it helps you basically understand all these issues. And for example, some practices I've seen which helped me a lot was like developers regularly viewing user reviews on Google App Store or App Store or Google Play, or sitting with the tech support guy and to see what are the common pain points of your users, what are they complaining about regularly, or see if your product manager is doing A/B testing. Try to see the numbers. Try to see what numbers help him make data-driven decisions. Try to see what is going on in his head. And last but not the least, personally, there was nothing more enlightening for me to see your real users using your app. And you will be shit surprised to know that the button you have put so obvious is he cannot even see it. And this feeling changes you forever. So I would highly recommend if you get a chance to be a part of any design thinking process, go for it. It will really change your thought process. And yeah, it's okay to say no. We developers tend to love building things. We are always ready to jump onto building things and because we love challenges, we love technical challenges, but it takes discipline to say no and abide by it. By saying no, I mean resisting when needed. Resisting to a feature, resisting to a change which kind of violates certain principles, a change which might create negative impact in the user experience or which might incur a huge dev cost but doesn't add any value. There's another misconception that I have personally observed that your stakeholders or your PMs are sometimes heavily obsessed with OKRs and KPIs, and they most of the time care about revenue and user session value. So I see developers as the last line of defense, actually, because they are the guys who should resist if something they request but violates the design principles or the principles of your platform. So try to say no, try to share your concerns as effectively as possible, and I think this is the only reason how you can educate them and help them understand what things can go wrong for their bad decisions. And yeah, as developers, we need to show empathy to our users, but before we show empathy, we need to see beyond ourselves, beyond our technical challenges. We have to really engage with our designers, understand our users, be more closer to our users, and see the bigger picture, and only then I think we can really effectively contribute with our work and craft. Thank you so much for listening.